Hey, hi. So in today's episode of Pytholic, what we are going to do is we are going to learn about installing Eclipse. And that is one of the best IDEs that I have used. I have personally used it for Python and for Python projects. And it is very good. I'll tell you that. It's very good. And the user interface is also very good and clean. And if you do like it, please make sure you give it a try. Okay, so let's see how it works. So the first thing that you're going to do is basically go to the Eclipse website. You can just type Eclipse, okay. And the first thing that will come up is like www.eclipse.org, and you can go ahead and click that. Okay, so you have a lot of information here. Don't worry about that. You will find a download section here. You can just go ahead and click that. Okay, so based on your system requirements, you can either install the 32 version or the 64 version. And we have Eclipse IDE 2020-03, and I'm going to download the 64-bit version. Okay, and it is giving a mirror image here, so I can just choose the mirror and I can download it, and you can just save it. So it will take some time for you to download based on your internet speed. Don't worry about it, it will take less time. So once it is downloaded, you can just click on that and open it. Okay. So the next thing is, if you don't have Java installed on your machine, you can go ahead and install it. It will open an auto downloader page where you can go ahead and download it. So I'll install the latest version of JDK here. We have Oracle JDK, so we can go ahead and install it. So if you're using Linux, you can go ahead for the Debian version or the RPM or the tar.gz file. And if you're using the Mac OS, you can go for the DMG or the tar.gz based on your requirement. I'm using Windows, so I will use the exe. Just click on that, accept the review clause, and download it. For this, you might need to sign in to the Oracle page. Don't worry about it. You can create an account if you don't have. Once you have logged in the site, it'll automatically allow you to get a pop-up where you will get the download, and you can just save it. So once it is downloaded, you can just click on that and open it. The installation has started successfully for us. Click on next. Click on next. Don't mess up with the path ever. Okay. If you don't know what to do, just follow the instructions. We'll just wait for a couple of minutes for it to complete, so don't worry. So to install Eclipse, you need Java. Make sure you download that. If you already have Java installed, it'll work just fine. Okay. Don't worry about it. Most of the developers right now are having Java installed already in their machine, so I think it'll just work fine. Okay, so now the installation has completed successfully. You can just go ahead and close it. So once you have installed Java, what you need to do is you need to go back to the download section where you have the executable, and you can just double click on that and run it again. Okay, yes, the installer has started. So we can proceed further with the installation of Eclipse. That's a big achievement, everyone. This lockdown has made everyone really crazy. And I also want to know, how is your lockdown? How is your lockdown going on right now? You can comment that in the comment section below, like, what's your lockdown type like? How is it going for you? Okay, so that we can interact. Okay, so now as you have started the installation, what you need to do is you need to just click on Eclipse IDE for Java developers. Okay. You will not find anything that will be for Python explicitly. Okay, you have many options. If you want to use for Java, you can use it. For C++ also it is there, for PHP, okay, and for DSL, and for Rust also it is there, but we need to install it for Java developers. Okay, don't worry, we'll be making it Python compatible. Just click on this, and you have the VM already detected, Java VM already detected here. The installation folder is already set. Don't change it until and unless you want to explicitly. Just go ahead and install it. Okay. Accept the terms and conditions. That's really important, if you know how much important it is. I seriously don't understand why they keep it. Nobody actually knows. Everybody just ignores it.
I'm listening.
In this lockdown, the only person who is listening to you is your iPhone. When suddenly it starts speaking, I am listening. Whenever I haven't even spoken about a single word about, hey Siri.
I'm listening.
She's listening. Good. So the warning that you see here is basically Java actually is, for Java developers, you need artifacts, okay, for the programs to process. So these artifacts may take a bit of time while downloading, but don't worry about it. It'll complete successfully. Don't worry about it. Okay. See, I told you it'll install successfully. Okay. So now just click on launch. I know we don't have much time to read the readme file, but it's okay. Just boot it. I'm really very excited to share this with you because this is one of the IDEs that I have been using since a very long time. And this is pretty good actually. I'll tell you the features in a very short time. So keep watching and give me the watch time. So this is the basic idea of having a directory space or workspace launcher. Just follow the same process or the instruction. If you want to change the workspace location, you can browse it to a particular folder by clicking on browse. And if you don't, just follow the same thing. It will install it in your user directory. Just click on launch. Yes, it has finally opened. So what we're going to do is we are just going to jump into the workbench. Okay. So here there are a lot of things that you can ignore right now. You can just proceed to the workbench here. You can see the icon for workbench, right? So you can just click on this one and go to the workbench. That is where all the magic happens. Okay. So this is the workbench here. You can find the project explorer here. You can find the task list here, and you can find the outlines for the editor that you have. And if you want to see the description of the problems or the declarations, you can just check that here. Okay. But the main thing that we want to do is basically we want to run Python, isn't it? So for that, we need a Python integrator. Okay, PyDev integrator. So for that, you need to go to Google again. You have to search PyDev for Eclipse. Okay, click on the pydev.org link. Okay, so this is the PyDev site. And here, what you're going to do is you're going to search for installing with the update site. Okay, just come down and you will see the PyDev locations. Okay, the PyDev URLs, and you have to choose the latest version. Okay, you can choose the nightly build or update sites, but you have to choose pydev.org/updates. Okay, copy this link and see. I'll tell you, you can find the installation steps here as well, but I'll show you because I already know that. Okay, sorry. So now what happens is you have to come back to your IDE. Okay, you see your files, edit, navigation, search, project, run, Windows, help. Okay, here you have, under help, you have install new software. Okay, once you click on install new software, it will present you with a dialog box which says available software. You can see here all the available packages that are with the Eclipse IDE. Will not do anything with this. You're going to add the new site. Okay, click on add, type PyDev. Okay, paste the location that you had copied previously. Okay, pydev.org/updates. okay, you just hit add. Okay, then just hit add. So there are two things that will come here, PyDev and PyDev Mylan integration, that is optional. So we'll just select PyDev and we'll proceed further. Okay, so add the site. Okay, then select PyDev, click on next. So basically it will install dependencies that you need to run your Python project. Okay, so now you have the next step here where you can just click on next and you can now accept the agreements. Okay, this is for the public license agreement, so just click on accept. And the next thing that you see here is a finish button. Go ahead and click that. So now that you see it, it has already started the installation. So one more security warning will come. Warning: installing unsigned software for which the authenticity or validity cannot be established. Continue with the installation. Yes. Restart Eclipse IDE to apply the software update. Why not? Please, let's restart it. Now everything is set. Okay. How can you verify that Python is compatible with this Eclipse IDE? Go to Windows, select Preferences, and here you will see PyDev. Okay, then you can just click on the drop down and you will see all the options that you can edit for Python. So what we want for Python? We basically want to execute Python scripts, right? So we need the interpreter. just click on the drop down here and select the Python interpreter, and here you have the option to add your Python exe. Okay, so there are a lot of options here for you to add Python to the path. You can either browse for the python.exe file, or you can start new with pip environment, or you can configure the path first, or you can choose from the list. Okay, if you click on choose from the list, it will automatically identify which one do you want. Okay, so this is the perfect way to understand how things work here. Okay, so this is where basically our Python exe is. Okay, the username, app data, local programs, python 38-32. I'll close it again and I'll start from scratch once again. See, choose from the list, click on choose from the list. Okay, it'll automatically choose and it'll automatically detect where the Python has been installed. Okay, either you can deselect all these things, okay, or else you can click all these things. Based on what happens here is it can also import all the site packages and the DLLs and libraries as well. Okay, so make sure that you have all the checkboxes ticked. But if suppose you have two versions of Python installed in the single machine and it has detected all of them, make sure you choose one of the version, either Python 2 or Python 3. Okay, I have everything as Python 3, so I don't have any problems with this, and I can just go ahead and click OK. Okay, but for you, if suppose you have two versions installed, make sure you select only one, either Python 2 or Python 3. So now it will detect all the packages that I have already installed using Python, and that's it. You have already configured your Python with your Eclipse, or the Python interpreter with Eclipse. So you can just click on apply and close, or apply whatever you want. Okay, and now it will restore the Python path. But so many people face a lot of problems while installing Python with Eclipse. A lot of people actually, because there are compatibility issues with Java and the Eclipse version that you use and other things as well. So if you find any problems like that, or if you face any problems like that, please comment them in the comment section below. Okay, so that if you find any resolutions for that, you can help someone else by putting the same in the comment section. Okay, so what you can do is, now you can go to the Project Explorer page. Okay, and you can just create a project. Okay, you can click on create a project. So if suppose you don't have any projects already there, you can just right click on this space and you can get the option for creating a new project. As we don't have any projects here, what it is trying to tell us, you can choose one of these three options to create your project, or you can import them as well. Okay, like if suppose you already have a Python project and you want to import it, or Eclipse project you want to import it, you can do that. So I'll start it once again. I am in the Project Explorer page, okay, or the window, and I'm going to click on create a project. Click on create a project, go to PyDev section, click on the drop down, select PyDev project. Okay, you can create Django project also in this one. Tell me, isn't it great? Yes, it is. Once you have selected PyDev project, what you can do is you can just click on next. You can give it a name, Superman. Okay, and you can choose the project type as Python. Obviously we are working on Python, so we'll choose Python. And you can select one of these version of Python. I'll choose same as the interpreter. I already set the interpreter. And the next thing that you want to do is you can choose the interpreter as Python. What you can do is you can add the project directory to your Python path. You can choose a default path location for your project. I have the same as my workspace, so I'm going to select the same and just click on finish. Open perspective. It'll open the perspective for you to work on Python. Okay, it'll be different than Java. So now this is ready. The first thing that we always do is create a Python package. Okay, PyDev package, and give it Batman. Okay, we have created the Python package. Remember, every Python package that you create will have an init file. Basically, it is the identifier for that. Okay, so what you can do is just right click on Batman, create a new PyDev module. Okay, so this is basically creating a file. So hello.py. If you are creating a Python module, don't be stupid like me. Don't type .py. It'll already take it as a py extension. Okay, just type hello or the file name that you want and click on finish. And you can choose one of these preset templates also. Okay, if you want to create a CLI argparse or argparse, or you want to create a class, okay, or you want to write a unit test with setup and teardown, you can choose one of these templates. I don't want to choose any templates. Okay, I'll just select the empty and click on OK. The best thing that any IDE you can do is, the first thing, the stupidest thing that you can do is you can assign a value. Okay. Hello world. This is the most versatile program that anyone can write. So we'll write this and then you can print. This is okay. So how do we run this? You can just right click on the file here, click on Python run, or else you can go to the file directly here and click on run, or else you can click on here as well, the play button that you see here, you can click here as well. But for this you have to set the configuration. So now let's suppose I click on this one, what happens? Okay, select the way to run hello.py. you can just click on Python run, okay, and click on OK. This is Hello World, and thanks for watching. So I hope you got the idea of how it works. There is one more thing that I want to tell you. Most of the times what happens is, if you are using a basic IDE, it will not tell you, or it will not warn you, if there are syntax errors or there are variable mismatches or if you're doing something wrong. Here in Eclipse, you can have a pylint enabled for this one. Okay, so if you go to editors, you see your code analysis. Okay, you see your pylint here. Now what happens is, you can choose this option, or you can, and you can choose this option here, use pylint, and it will warn you on all the PEP8 errors, okay, or warnings. So I'll go ahead and click on this one. So after this, what you need to do is, you need to come to code analysis. Okay, you have to just click on code analysis. Okay, if you click on pylint, it'll go here. If you go click on code analysis, it'll come here. So here you see pycode style.py. Okay, that is pep8. Choose one of these options. Okay, it can just give you information, or you can select it to give you a warning, or else you can select it to give you an error as well. Okay, so what you can do is, I'll just go ahead and select warning. Okay, and then you can just apply that. See, pycode analysis is working now. See, now you got W391 blank line at end of file. See, I told you this works. Okay, so let's suppose I give a garbage, no new line. Okay, now I have to give a new line. Now it will tell multiple spaces after keywords. Okay, so you saw how simple it is, and basically there are other many good features in this one, like you can integrate Git with it as well. Okay, if you want to install Git, you have to go to the Eclipse marketplace and you can integrate Git as well. You can, so let's suppose you want to commit your code directly from here, you can do that. So eGit is one of the best plugins available for Eclipse for Git. So you can just, I have already installed it. It's a good thing. Okay, so you can just right click on this one. You see teams here, right? So now as it is not a Git project, what it is telling is, it is, you have to configure it manually. So you can go ahead and configure it. But if suppose you're working on a Git repository and you import it to Eclipse, you can directly commit your files, push them, pull the latest code. You can do everything from here. Okay, that's a really beautiful aspect of using Eclipse. And you see, it's a very simple interface. There is no dark mode. Okay, dark mode is really garbage in Eclipse. Don't use that. But if you like, you can go ahead and use it. So this was the first part of the IDE series that I have. IDE, there are three parts. Okay, the first one will be Eclipse. The second one will be Visual Studio. The third one will be PyCharm. I'll be explaining all these three in depth so that you get to choose the right IDE for yourself. So if you really like this video and the way I explained or anything, please do try this IDE. I hope you'll really like it. And if you do, please comment on what you liked, what you didn't. Okay, so I hope you're aware of the giveaway contest that we are having right now. Three members of our Python family are going to win a surprise gift, okay, on 1st June. And to participate in that, you have to go to the link in the description below and comment on what is your favorite programming language and why. Okay, and make sure you do participate. 1st June is the date we are going to announce the winners. So please make sure you go to the link in the description below. On that video, go to the comment section and comment on what is the favorite programming language and why. And make sure you do participate. That's it from my side today. It's your friend Pytholic signing off.